All right, let's talk about something that sounds kind of complicated, but is actually super important for anyone dealing with money. And let's be real, that's pretty much all of us. We're diving into the difference between real and nominal interest rates. And trust me, understanding this can totally change how you look at a loan, a mortgage, or even your savings. So let's get into it. So picture this. You walk into a bank and they offer you a loan with a 2% interest rate. I mean, that sounds amazing, right? It's a low number, seems super straightforward. But is that 2% the whole story? Is that really what you're going to end up paying? Well, as you've probably guessed, not always. And that's what brings us to what I like to call the interest rate illusion. See, the number you see on the poster or in the ad isn't always the complete picture of what your loan is going to cost you. And to see right through this illusion, you got to understand the two main types of interest rates out there, the nominal rate and the real rate. Okay, first up, let's talk about the nominal interest rate. Honestly, the best way to think about this is like the sticker price on a car. It's the simple, advertised price you see right up front. No tricks, no hidden clauses. It's the number they tell you. So what is it exactly? Well, a nominal interest rate is just a fixed rate. It's not tied to whatever's going on with inflation or the economy. If the bank says the rate is 5%, you pay 5%. That's it. End of story. It's a simple, predictable number that isn't going to change. Now, let's flip the coin and look at the other side, the real interest rate. If the nominal rate is that sticker price, you should think of the real rate as the true cost of borrowing. This is where things start to get a little more interesting. The huge difference here, the absolute key, is that this rate is linked to the consumer price index, which is just the official way we measure inflation. And that means a real interest rate isn't a fixed number. Nope, it's actually a moving target that goes up and down with the cost of living. So let's look at how this actually works using that 2% example from the beginning. If you have a 2% real interest rate, you don't just pay 2%. You start with that 2% base rate, but then you have to add the current rate of inflation on top of it. So your total cost is constantly changing as the economy changes. And that brings us to the secret ingredient, the hidden factor that changes everything, inflation. That's the thing that separates a simple nominal rate from a more complex real rate. It's this invisible force that can totally alter the true cost of your loan over time. So let's just put them head to head to make it crystal clear. The nominal rate, that's the simple advertised rate. It has nothing to do with the price index. It's basically what you see is what you get. But the real rate, that's the rate after you factor in inflation. It's directly tied to the price index. It's not what you see, it's what you truly pay. Okay, so theory is one thing, but why does any of this actually matter for you and your wallet? Well, knowing the difference here is absolutely crucial when you're making big financial moves, whether you're buying a house, getting a car loan, or even just picking a savings account. Check this out. At first glance, a 5% nominal rate loan seems way more expensive than a 2% real rate loan, right? But what if inflation is at 3%? Well, suddenly that 2% real rate becomes 2% plus that 3% for inflation, which is 5%. They actually end up costing the exact same amount. The really important difference isn't the final number in this one case, it's about predictability. With the nominal loan, your cost is fixed. With the real loan, your cost could go up or down depending on what inflation does next. So if you only take one thing away from all of this, let it be this. The next time you're offered a loan or any kind of interest rate, just ask one simple question. Is this rate linked to the price index or not? The answer to that question tells you everything you need to know about the real deal. So there you have it. You now have the key to see right through that interest rate illusion. You know that the sticker price isn't always a true cost. And with that knowledge, you're way better prepared to handle your financial future. The only question left is, how are you going to use it?